That's how they come in with this? This how they come in?
Got Bruce in here, man. Feel me?
Righteous, man.
Oh, no, where we at, man? Where we at?
Hey, man, we at the Palm Suites, man. Okay, we okay. So high in the motherfucking sky right now.
Oh, man, oh, man. I'm gonna get it right, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
What's up with YouTube? This is Cuz by Matt. It's my first video, first upload. I'm just showing off this little Wavelength cut I did on my boy Bruce in Vegas at the Palms. Right now, I just combed out his hair, taking everything down to the 1.5, lever all the way open with my wall, Corliss Senior, leaving the blade and the clipper very flat. Get everything nice and even before we start the tapers. Going around all around his head. When I'm going around his head, I want to make sure that my blade is all the way open, so that way we don't cut as much off. Being very careful around the crown area, you can make a patch if you're not careful. It's going all around nice and even. In the back too. All right, now we're about to start the back taper. Creating my first guideline with my Gold FX trimmer. I use the end of the ears to direct me where I should create the guideline. We want to make sure we make good guidelines, neat, clean, so that way we don't have to have a messy fade. I'm gonna start the taper with my first guideline, lever all the way closed, going up like a centimeter. This guideline is just to make sure I don't create any harsh guidelines to remove, make everything nice and smooth. After that, I'm gonna make a 1-inch guideline with the lever all the way open with a scooping motion. Not really trying to make a harsh guideline. Then to remove the guideline, I put the lever back all the way closed, just using the corners of my blade, making sure my blade is laid flat on the skin. And we're not trying to make another guideline, we're just removing using the corners. And right here, I'm using a technique called lever play, and I'm just going up and down with the lever just to make sure I remove the guideline as best as possible before I go on to the next step. All right, for this next guideline, I brought out my Oster fast feed, got the number 0 guard, the half guard, lever all the way closed, and we're making up, I say, half an inch to an inch of a guideline. To erase this guideline, I got my lever all the way open, no guard, just flicking out, keeping the blade very flat, trying to remove the guideline as best as possible. Following up, after the 0 closed, I got my 0 all the way open, creating a 1-inch guideline, and I'm pretty much just getting each guard and I'm making a guideline with the lever closed and open, and then using the previous guard to remove the guideline. Like I said, going back to the previous step, got my lever all the way closed to remove the guideline, making sure everything's nice and smooth, all guidelines are erased. My number 1 guard will be the highest guard I use on this haircut because he has a 1.5 on top, so this will be my last guard I'll be using. And this is the final guideline. For this part of the taper, I got my number one guard all the way open, and I'm going with the waves, going with the grain, just removing any dark areas, any light spots as well, I'm trying to blend in everything right above the occipital bone. Now I'm just detailing with the number one guard and all the way closed, making sure all the guidelines that I created are removed and making sure everything's nice and blurry. For the sides, we're doing mid-ball tapers, and I start the guideline around the top of the ear, and I'm using the corners of my blade to create my guideline, making sure everything's nice and neat and bald. For the side tapers, I'm pretty much using the same techniques I did on the back, but since it's a smaller area, I'm just using the corners of my blade to remove and create the guidelines. Since I'm doing mid tapers, I think it's useful if I use the corners of the blade instead of the full blade to remove and create the guidelines. It maintains shape and it keeps you from going any higher on your taper. When you're dealing with waves, you always want to fade downwards, turning over the clipper and making sure you go with the grain, just blending everything down, removing any dark spots. So this is the best part of a cut, in my opinion, the lineup, and we're just keeping everything nice and natural. Using the full blade, keeping everything nice and flat on my FX trimmers. You want to just go naturally where the hair grows. You don't want to ever dig in too deep or push anything back. For the line behind the ear, I'm just using the corners of my blade and in a C motion, just creating a half circle, keeping the line natural. For the front line, I start off in the middle. I've been cutting bro for a minute now, so I kind of already visualized how I want his line. I think the previous barber had pushed him just a little bit, so I'm gonna try my best to bring him back. Start off in the middle and work my way to the right. Just tap in the line. You don't want to push in too deep. It was hella dark in the bathroom, so I got my little camera light and I just pointed the light towards his head so I could see better. This side of the line was the part that needed to grow a little bit more. So I'm just tapping the line, not trying to push anything back. Pretty much just ghost lining the side. For the hooks or the C cups, I'm just using the corners of the blade and in a C motion, just creating the hook. Not digging in too deep or pushing anything back. right here. Just cleaning up the facial hair, making sure everything's nice and clean. You know, simple goatee, a little boxed out goatee. I think he was trying to grow a beard, but I don't think it's working for him. Right here, I'm just going over the type of game with the 1.5, lever all the way open. Just making sure I get all the hairs, making sure everything's nice and even. I comb down the hair again, so that way I know that all the flyaways are combed out. So that way I can line it one more time and attack all the hairs. And for more detail, with my FX trimmers, I'm just gliding the blade against the hair on top just to get any more flyaways or any hairs that the clipper wasn't able to get to. Now I'm bringing out my razor to finalize the line. I'm keeping the blade very flat, stretching out the skin, and being very careful, just shaving the hairs that needs to be cut. The blade is very sharp, so I'm trying to make sure I don't cut him or dig in too deep. For this cut, I didn't add any spray or fiber enhancement, but I did use the white color pencil to create a natural ash line. And right now I just created the line with the pencil, and now I'm using my trimmers to blend in the line so that way it doesn't look too white. And I feel like this is perfect for his hair. Now I'm just finalizing the cut, finishing everything up, razoring his goatee, making sure all stubbles are cut, everything that needs to be shaved or cut off. I'd probably recommend you don't use the razor on the mustache unless you got some type of experience. You know, you don't want to be cutting lips and shit, so be very careful if you do try it at home. At this point, I'm just detailing the cut, making sure everything's nice and sharp. Just wanna give a huge shout out to my boy Bruce for giving me this opportunity. It's my first time flying out just to cut hair. But yeah, y'all, this is a Wavelength cut, 1.5 on top with mid tapers. I hope y'all mess with it. I know my boy did. We'll see y'all in the next one. How you feel, brother? Up, y'all. That was my little vlog slash run through with the cut, man. Yeah, man, I'm new to this YouTube stuff, man, so I'm gonna come out on my show for y'all, post more. It's the beginning, so shit. Yeah, I don't know what else to say, but just know I got y'all, and it's gonna be a start, gang.
Holy.